Did you know that you can go live from StreamYard right on your mobile device? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you just how you can do that. So stay right there. That's what's coming up right now. Well, in order for me to go live with StreamYard from my iPhone, I need to first open the Safari browser. You may need to run a speed test, and I recommend having at least 8 or 9 megabits per second of upload speed. That's the important number. Go into your phone settings and turn on Do Not Disturb. The next thing I like to do, if I'm doing a landscape broadcast, is I want to turn my phone so that the camera is on my left. Here's the advantage of having your camera over on your left-hand side, is that you'll be able to easily navigate through all of the different areas of the dashboard without your finger getting in front of the camera. So that's super important. So you also can see comments, and you also would be able to access any of your banners that you've had, that you've created maybe for previous shows. And then you also have access to your branding. So if you want to change the color of the way your name appears on screen, or your guest name, you also can change the different themes that StreamYard has provided for us. So this was the default theme. This one's minimal. This one's bubble. And this one is block. Then you can add logos. So there's the old classic mallard duck, StreamYard duck. There's my Ileane Smith logo. You can also add overlays. So here's the StreamYard overlay that's built in, but you can upload your own overlays as well. You just have to make sure that they are transparent PNG files. The other thing you can do is add video clips. These are great to add as intros and outros, or maybe even you want to add as a transition. You can add videos there as well. And last but not least, you can add a background image so that depending upon the different layout that you're using, you will see the background. Now, there's also the more option. So you see the little 3-dot menu right below me. When I click that on, I can post comments. I can change my layout. I can have a private chat with my guest. I can edit the broadcast information, and I can change settings. So one of the things I could do if I change the settings is to change the destinations that I'm broadcasting to. Maybe I started my broadcast in a private Facebook group, and then I decided that I wanted to go live on my Facebook page or on YouTube. Great way to give behind the scenes content to your fans. And my guest has arrived, and I just add my guest to the stream. And there you have where we go to the 3 dots. And now I can change the different layouts. For example, I can try this layout. And if I want to put the guest in on the left and myself on the right, I can do that as well. Let's go back over into the layouts and try a different layout. If I wanted to have the guest smaller, or I can again change that around and the guest broadcast can be larger and my view can be smaller. So much that you can do when you live stream from StreamYard from your mobile device. Go ahead and check it out. And if you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below and we'll answer right away. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.